An SRL is a self-retracting lifeline. Some of the common names that we'll hear is a block, a solid block, a yo-yo, are some of the slang terms that are used for a self-retracting lifeline or SRL. ANSI, with their Z359.14 standard, has broken SRLs into a few different categories, from SRL-LE, which are the leading edge devices, which may be leading edge, and they may be leading edge, sharp edge devices. SRL-R devices, which are devices that can provide rescue built right into the systems. We have SRDs, self-retracting devices, which are more of the personal size devices that are meant to replace the traditional lanyard. There are a lot of different styles out there. We have styles that are cable, we have styles that are web, we have styles that have been developed for hot work, for use when people are welding or grinding around higher temperature work activities. We have devices that have been developed for arc flash, for when people are working in high voltage applications, or electrical workers that are working at heights around high voltage panels that can withstand those up to 40 calorie arc flash blasts. So there's gone are the days where an SRL block yo-yo was a piece of cable or a web, and it was one size fits most, to devices that are highly specialized and made for very, very specific work activities, tasks, or protecting workers in very specific dangers.
And in the beginning, I was counting pennies, and I bought, you know, the first thing I bought were the ropes and the roof mounts, because they're the cheapest. And you can get like a fairly inexpensive harness in a bucket for like $100. You know, any lumber yard's gonna sell them. I was doing some apartments for R&H, or there were townhomes called Penn's Place, and I'm on the roof, and I got a gun in one hand and I got a saw in the other, and I'm all tied off, and I step on my safety rope and it rolled under the heel of my foot and I landed on my tailbone. I don't know if you've ever done that, but it's excruciatingly painful. Well, that taught me that it's well worth the extra $1,000 to buy a retractable, because the retractable, as you're walking, it always sucks the slack up. There's always tension and you can't trip on your safety gear. Whereas the cheaper ropes, you manually must always adjust the length, and that's in theory, but in reality, most guys don't, and they drag around a surplus of rope. And invariably, like I discovered that day, you end up not seeing the rope when it's behind you on a roof and it's uphill. And then when you step on it, it rolls by virtue of just physics, and then you fall. My philosophy now is retractables when possible. I have some really old guys. I mean, I got probably five guys that are late 50s to early 60s. The retractables are hard on their backs. So I don't put them on a roof, but if I do, and usually it'd be like a flat roof, they're gonna wear a rope because it doesn't pull on their back. So I still own probably four ropes, but we almost never use them.